everyone. How's everybody doing today? I'm here with students from Wakefield High School in Arlington, Virginia. And we've got students tuning in from across America, kindergarten through 12th grade. I'm glad you all could join us today. I know that many of you, today is the first day of school. And for those of you in kindergarten, or starting middle school, or high school, it's your first day in a new school. So it's understandable if you're a little nervous. I imagine there are some seniors out there who are feeling pretty good right now, with just one more year to go. No matter what grade you're in, some of you are probably wishing it were still summer, and you could have stayed in bed just a little bit longer this morning. I know that feeling. When I was young, my family lived in Indonesia for a few years. My mother didn't have money to send me where all the American kids went to school. So she decided to teach me lessons herself, Monday through Friday at 4:30 in the morning. Now, I wasn't too happy about getting up that early. A lot of times, I'd fall asleep right there at the kitchen table. But whenever I'd complain, my mother would just give me that look and say, "This is no picnic for me either, Buster." So I know some of you are still adjusting to being back at school. But I'm here today because I have something important to discuss with you. I'm here because I want to talk with you about your education and what's expected of all of you in this new year. Now, I've given a lot of speeches about education, and I've talked a lot about responsibility. I've talked about your teacher's responsibilities for inspiring you and pushing you to learn. I've talked about your parents' responsibilities for making sure you stay on track, you get your homework done, and you don't spend every waking hour watching TV or with the Xbox. I've talked a lot about our government's responsibilities for setting high standards, supporting teachers, principals, and turning around schools that aren't working, where students aren't getting the opportunities they deserve. But at the end of the day, we can have the most dedicated teachers, the most supportive parents, and the best schools in the world, and none of it will matter unless all of you fulfill your responsibilities. Unless you show to those schools, pay attention to those teachers, listen to your parents, grandparents, or other adults, and put in the hard work it takes to succeed. And that's what I want to focus on today, the responsibility each of you has for your education. I want to start with the responsibility you have to yourself. Every single one of you has something you're good at. Every single one of you has something to offer. And you have the responsibility to yourself to discover what that is. That's the opportunity an education can provide. Maybe you could be a good writer. Maybe even good enough to write a book, an article in the newspaper. But you might not know it until you write a paper for your English class. Maybe you could be an innovator or an inventor. Maybe even good enough to come up with the next iPhone, or a new medicine, or a vaccine. But you might not know it until you do a project in your science class. Maybe you could be a mayor, or a senator, or a Supreme Court justice. But you might not know that until you join student government or the debate team. And no matter what you want to do with your life, I guarantee that you'll need an education to do it. You want to be a doctor or a teacher or a police officer? You want to be a nurse or an architect, a lawyer, or a member of our military? You're going to need a good education for every single one of those careers. You can't drop out of school and just drop into a good job. You've got to work hard for it and train for it and learn for it. And this isn't just important for your own life and your own future. What you make of your education will decide nothing less than the future of this country. What you're learning in today's school will determine whether we as a nation can meet our greatest challenges in the future.